Now, you want to be able to keep your upper body relaxed. Tai Chi will give you strong legs, and strong legs will enable you to relax your upper body. So, you don't want to let the tension from your leg creep up into your upper body, causing you to perhaps pull your stomach in, lift your shoulders, maybe lift your elbows. You want to try and let your shoulders hang under gravity and for your belly to expand. Don't hold it in. If you hold it in, you restrict your breathing. Everything lowered under gravity. A strong, stable leg and a relaxed upper body. That doesn't mean you crumple. You do need to keep your posture and hold your posture, but only with the necessary amount of tension. And then let everything else hang off it. If we talk about the upper back, we could do this in horse stance. What you want to try and do, well, a common mistake with beginners is to lift their chin and to compress this area of the neck. You want to bring your chin in, and if anything, it almost feels like you're stretching the skin on the back of your neck. But you're raising the top of your head, bringing your chin in, and placing your head above your body. If I take it in a back stance here, you can see that if I do this, I'm all my neck muscles here. I have them support my head and hold it in front of me. If you can bring your chin in, you can then relax this area a lot more because it's just sitting in a straight line, as if you're balancing a pole on your hand. You're balancing your whole body. That way you're able to relax a lot more. That way you're able to relax the belly. Bring the head back in here. And don't force it back stiffly, but having got it there, then try and relax. As you perform movements, try and remember to keep it in that position. The hands are quite interesting. You want to try and have the hands in Fair Lady's hand. What we were trying to do is eliminate tension in the hand. So splaying your fingers like this is tense. Putting them tightly together is tense. They do say there shouldn't be a gap big enough to fit another finger and that the fingers shouldn't touch. Have them slightly cupped, so don't put tension and have them straight or crooked like so. Try and have them relaxed. And usually, unless they're actually doing something like a palm strike, usually you're straight at the back of the wrist. Like so. And soft. Tendency, as I say, with beginners, is that when they start doing a movement, they forget their hands and they'll do crumple or something. Or they might do a difficult move and suddenly fingers go. Try and keep your hands soft and more or less in Fair Lady's hand the whole time. Don't crumple them. So it might seem a bit fussy, but to keep the hands in this Fair Lady's. But you have a large area of your brain which controls the movement of your hands. A far larger area of your brain controls your hands than the rest of your body. There's also quite a large area on your face and your tongue, but you are going to try and keep them still too. So, in other words, if you're doing the hand form and you're tensing up your hands, then you've got quite a large area of your brain in tension as well. And in Tai Chi we're trying to control the whole body. So, hands are important too, and in fact, hands are very important. So when you start the form off and when you start to move your arms, as you raise your arms, let your shoulders remain under gravity and staying down. If I do it incorrectly, it's very common with beginners, is to raise their shoulders when they raise their arms. This pulls the stomach in and tightens up here, which will mean that your breath is shallow. You want to allow this area to expand just by letting go of it. That means the diaphragm will move down as you breathe, everything will stay down. Likewise, bring the shoulders up, keep the breast shallow. Keep this area relaxed throughout the whole form. Don't constrict your breath. The problem usually is that people hold their breath, which means that they tend to hold their stomach in and breathe shallowly. Allow this area to be relaxed at all times, so that as you're performing movements, at no point do you hold your breath. You're just allowing your breath to flow in and out as it wants. You'll probably breathe out with an outward movement. So for instance, in Grasp the Bird's Tail, you'll probably breathe out here. But don't try and breathe out there. If you're relaxed, if you keep your posture correct, your breath will flow naturally Like a baby or like an animal. So, tension here, lifting the shoulders will hinder your breath, will stop it flowing naturally. So I choose a Taoist art, and we're trying to go back to doing things naturally.